Hi guys, welcome back to The Social Tune, and today we are going to be taking a look at the latest album by Logic called Everybody. Hell of a long way from equal ecstatic treatise, body of a builder with the mind of a fetus. Turn on the television and see the vision they feed us, and I wish I could erase that face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know how it goes. So for all my talk about how much I love hip-hop and rappers like Kendrick Lamar, Childish Gambino, and Lupe Fiasco, I've never really talked about Logic, not even in passing. And believe it or not, there's actually a reason for that. Namely that Logic is on my short list of artists who I respect and like and admire, but who everyone else seems to love a lot more than I do. Don't get me wrong, he's a pretty great rapper, but so often he trips himself up, either with inconsistent production or recycling material, or quite simply not diving into things as deeply as he otherwise could. Now this was definitely not true of his breakout album Under Pressure, which remains his best in my opinion, but his follow-up, The Incredibly True Story, while very ambitious, couldn't quite match it. And considering the frankly astounding amount of people debating whether or not this album was even good, I went into this with a sinking feeling that this was going to be one of Logic's weaker projects. And yeah, I was right. This isn't a bad album by any means, but it's definitely his weakest so far, for very clear and obvious reasons. And the place to start our discussion comes with the production. That's that road I've been down, I know how it go down, I know how it go, now what's up? I feel like I don't belong, I feel like my life is wrong, I feel like I don't know what's up. What's up? What's up? Yeah! Okay, now I'll be honest, the production across this album is pretty damn solid. You get the soul and the gospel and the pretty elated piano line on Black Spiderman, the more fast-paced and tight melody with light bass touches on Everybody, or the spacey echoing vocals and strings on Hallelujah. And then you have the twinkling melody and the orchestral backing vocals on Inkblot. Some of these instrumentals are really bright, vibrant, and colorful, just like his last album. But on the other hand, a lot of this production sounds, well, pretty cheap. Take the fake drums and the extremely processed piano on Confess, or the tinny instrumental on Africarian. And then you have Killing Spree with one of the most unlogic choruses and instrumentals that I've ever heard. It did not suit him. Although, at the very least, it wasn't the honking, distorted mess of African that was borderline unlistenable, really wasn't a fan of that. So to sum up, the production is bright and sunny, except when it's not, and is overall a lot cheaper sounding than it probably should be. And then you have the artists on this album. Take it back, take it way, way back to the first black man. Long ago before the white man could paint a black man with a gun in his hand. Take it way back, take it way, way back to the first white man. At the very moment when he looked around and said, fuck it, I'ma steal this land. Take it back, take it way back, take it way, way back to the first black man. And boy oh boy, this is a mixed bag indeed. On the one hand, Logic can rap pretty fast with a pretty elastic flow, but on the other hand, he repeats himself a lot, not just in his bars, but also in his content. And his singing is okay, I guess. It's basically if Drake cared a little bit more about what he was singing, although maybe not quite as melodic. Otherwise, well, Killer Mike is great, of course, but nowhere near his best. Honestly, I've heard him sound so much more broken and conflicted on so many of his own songs or with Run the Jewels that this really can't help but pale by comparison. And despite how much the message on 1-800-273-8255 is colossally mishandled, Alessia Cara does sound good on it, even if I still don't get the appeal of Khalid. At the very least, they both had more personality than Lucy Rose on Anxiety, who was a complete non-presence on that track. Juicy J is really basic on Inkblot, although, to be honest, the entire song felt very basic to me. And while Ansel Elgort's Post Malone impression is still nowhere near as grating as the original article, it still really did set my teeth on edge. Now, I will say that African is slightly redeemed by its guest stars, as they all deliver solid verses. Although, if you actually read along with the lyrics, you'll notice that none of their verses have anything to do with the track. They could be copy-pasted on any number of other songs and they would fit just as well. Surprisingly, one of the artists who actually felt the most potent to me was J. Cole on Africarian, as he encourages Logic to stop trying to define himself as black, white, biracial, or whatever, but simply as an artist, as an entertainer for people to look up to. Which I definitely agree with, because Logic has beaten these themes to death at this point, and he doesn't seem to want to take it anywhere new or innovative or insightful. Which takes us to, ultimately, the biggest issue with this album, the lyrics. I'm like, hallelujah, praise God, almighty, the most high, alpha and omega in the sky. I'm like, hallelujah, praise God, almighty, the most high, alpha and omega in the sky. I'm like, made in the image of God, with a blunt my mouth and a bitch on the side. Okay, you know how I said that Logic likes to recycle material? Well, here he took that to a whole new level, as we get song after song about pretty much the exact same thing. About how everybody's equal, how you should love everything about yourself, and most of all, how all of this relates back to Logic's personal struggle. Which is honestly my biggest problem with this album, the fact that no matter where the song tries to go, Logic always drags it back to be about him somehow. Which is kind of a shame, because as compelling as Logic can be, you kind of get sick of how often he repeats himself here. Especially considering that, well, his only real claim to wisdom is the fact that he's biracial. Which is great, and I'm glad he's willing to talk about it, but he never really takes it anywhere. For example, imagine how powerful it would be if he brought up white privilege despite not being white. Holy shit, that would blow Macklemore's song about it out of the water. But no, instead it's always about what a curse it was, as he goes on about how everyone, including his own white mother, treated him differently because of it. And the more I heard him repeat this and how ashamed he seems to be about his white side, the more I got the feeling that he was doing this purely for street cred. For an album that sounds so unique on paper, it really doesn't take any chances, which really does frustrate me. Prime example, take 1-800-273-8255. One of the worst songs on this album that tries to talk about suicide. And look, put aside the fact that putting Alessia Cara on this track reeks of pandering, especially considering her biggest hit, Scars to Your Beautiful, or that Khalid brings nothing to the track, the fundamental issue with this song is that it doesn't take itself seriously, with awkward lines, flubbed rhymes, and really bright production that doesn't fit it at all. And then you get the skits on this album, where a man called Adam dies and meets God, played by Neil deGrasse Tyson, who explains to Adam that he is the only human ever to have lived, having lived every single life that has ever existed, be it black, white, Asian, gay, straight, bi, meaning that we truly are all exactly the same. Which may sound deep and profound, until you stop to think about it for a moment. Because this completely eliminates individuality, free will, thinking for ourselves, love, hate, compassion. And then you remember, he died, so when he dies, does the world just go on hold? Or is he just reborn as the next person? And even then, there are hundreds of babies born every second, how does that work? Plus, God actually tells Adam that if he finds enough spiritual peace, he can retain the old lessons and memories that he has from his past lives. But who fucking cares? He's everyone. What can he possibly learn from that, other than the fact that he shouldn't hurt himself or offend himself? In which case, why did God even create him? To watch him kill himself, enslave himself, marry himself? And note that I'm just saying him here because his name is Adam. He's also every single woman, too. This has so many plot holes that it just hurts. And no, while I don't think that Logic actually believes this, instead using it all as a metaphor as to how we're all just so alike, this really does feel smug and conceited, especially considering that once again, all of this wisdom just comes from the fact that he's biracial. It just feels like he's talking down to me, which is not helped by the actual content of these songs. He's just way too out of his depth here, while simultaneously playing it way too safe. So at the end of the day, this album mostly sounds okay, Logic is a good rapper, and most of the guests are solid, but boy, did this give me a headache. The themes are ambitious and interesting on the surface, but logic squanders all of that potential to make something much more safe and basic. So yeah, it's a strong 5 out of 10. Check this out if you're a Logic fan, but otherwise, I would recommend you check out his last two albums. They're both much better than this. So thank you guys for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed. If there are any other albums coming out in the next month or so, please post them in the comments or tweet them at me at The Social Tune, link in the description. Please subscribe so you don't miss a thing, and until the next time, I'm Finn, and this is The Social Tune, signing off.